In this AUTOSOL training session, I'll be walking you through the ACM monitor. For this demonstration, I'll be using a computer with a Windows 7 operating system. The ACM monitor provides access to server-wide settings and status information. To open the ACM monitor, go to Start, All Programs, AUTOSOL Communication Manager, and select ACM monitor. The ACM monitor opens with the Status tab selected by default. This tab is used to monitor and control the ACM services and is also used to view the server information. Select the services you want to perform an action on or select all services by clicking on the Select All button. To start or stop the selected services, simply click on the Start or Stop Services button or right-click and select Start or Stop. If you're stopping services, a window will open asking you to confirm that you want to stop the selected services. The service control window will appear showing the status of the services as they are being started or stopped. If at any time during the process you wish to cancel the operation, simply press the cancel button. You can also change the user that the selected services are logged on as. Click the Change Login button or right-click and select Change User. This will open a window where you can configure the selected services to log on as a local system account or a specified account. If you choose a specified account, you will need to enter the account name and password before pressing OK to accept the changes. Please note that the service will need to be restarted for the changes to take effect. Some of the services within the ACM monitor are optional. By default, they are not displayed, but can be made visible by clicking the Show Optional Services checkbox. If you will not be using one of the optional services, you can disable it in your Windows Services. To do this, go to your Windows Services, open the Properties of the service, and in the General tab, set the Startup type to Disabled. Once you have disabled the service, it will no longer appear in the list of services until the Show Disabled Services checkbox has been selected. Disabled services will appear with a lock icon beside them. To start or re-enable the service, you will need to go back into your Windows Services. If the server is running, you are also able to view details about your operating system and ACM components by clicking on the Server Information button. If you are asked for this information when talking to AUTOSOL support, you can click on the Copy to Clipboard button and paste it into an email. When finished, you can click OK to close the Server Information window. Next, we have the Properties tab. When a property is selected, a description will appear below. The Gas Analysis Processing Blackout section is specifically for automated GC writes. It allows you to assign blackout times where ACM will not process any gas analysis requests. These properties are for the optional ASI GC Request Manager service. The Gas Analysis Write File Service section includes properties for when you are getting your GC values in a delimited file. These properties tell ACM how to read the file so that it can be interpreted by the optional ASI GC Write File service. The Gas Analysis Write section contains general GC Write properties for the ASI GC Request Manager service. The Gas Analysis Writes Retry section contains properties for retrying writes from the ASI GC Request Manager service. The Server section contains server level properties. These properties are required, but the default settings should work in most applications. The Total Flow Laptop File Import Service section contains properties for importing manually collected data from a Total Flow device. They are for the ASI Total Flow Manual Import service. Clicking the Save button will save your changes. The Reset button will change all properties back to their default settings. If selected, you will be asked for confirmation before the properties are reset. If you click off of the current tab or close the ACM configuration without saving, a pop-up will appear asking if you would like to save your changes. Next, we have the Database tab. The Database tab contains two sections, ACM Database and FlowCal Database. In the ACM Database section, click the Manage Database button. This will open the ACM database connection window. If you have an existing ACM database to connect to, fill in the connection information and test the connection. The test connection will be done with the user account that you are logged in as. If you do not have an existing ACM database, click the Create Update Database button. This will open the Create Database wizard. The wizard can create a new database for the ACM configuration. You can also use this wizard to update an existing database to include all of the tables and procedures required for the installed version of ACM. Or, if you already have a database created for ACM to use, it can create tables and procedures in an existing database with an option to drop existing tables first if you are reusing an old database. With any of these options, the wizard allows you to select the SQL database options. When selecting Simple, Bulk Logged, or Full, a description explaining how that recovery model works will be displayed in the text box below. Here, you can also select if you want ACM to delete old history and specify how many days of each history type you would like to keep. This is just for the tables that ACM references for publishing. These settings can also be changed in the $ server properties of the ACM configuration. Select Next. The last screen will describe how the database will be created. Once you have reviewed the description, select Finish to complete the required actions. Once you have completed the Create Database wizard, you can select the Test Connection button to make sure that your database configuration is working correctly. A window will appear telling you the result. Also in the ACM database window are the Safe Mode options. For details on Safe Mode, please see the ACM User Guide. Back on the Database tab, in the ACM Database section, click the Database Statistics button. This will open a window that will allow you to view your configuration database size and storage statistics, as well as view and manage the index statistics. Database management is usually taken care of by a database administrator. For more information on the database statistics and how they work, click on the Help button in the top left corner. Back on the Database tab, click the FlowCal Database button. This will open the Oracle Database Connection window. If you are using the FlowCal SCADA request functionality to automate GC writes from the FlowCal Transaction Queue database, this is where you configure the connection to the FlowCal Oracle database so that ACM can accept the validated GC data. For more information, please see the ACM User Guide. The next tab in the ACM Monitor is Reports. ACM can generate reports by doing a query of the configuration database. For this to be done, the report service requires a connection to the ACM database. It is recommended that a login be created in SQL Server for the report service that has read-only permissions. This is because reports can be created with custom queries. Read-only permissions would prevent someone writing changes to the database using a custom report query. Enter the connection information and test the connection. A window will pop up stating if the test was successful. Next is the Logging tab. ACM can be set up to log data traffic to and from the end device, detailed configuration properties on startup, and OPC trace data. Details on logging this data to disk are found in the Log Files section. If required, the location for the logger settings can be changed. You can also define a range of UDP ports for the logger to use in the UDP Setup section. The License tab is next. ACM is licensed by the number of devices in your configuration, not meters, protocols, points, or other objects. Your current license information is listed on this screen. When ACM is first installed, it will work unlicensed for 30 days. If you need a license, simply click on the License Request button. A pop-up window will open stating that all the information needed to request a license has been copied to the clipboard. Open a new email, paste the copied information into the email, and send it to the email address shown in the pop-up with the number of devices required. Once you have received your license file, save it on your ACM server. The default location for the license file is C, Program Data, AUTOSOL, Communication Manager, 7, License. Once saved, click on the License File ellipse, browse to the location that the file was placed, and select the file to display the license information. The last tab in the ACM monitor is System Files. System Files is the single location where all of the built-in external files are housed for ACM. If required, you can copy the files and select a different location. Please note that if you do change the System Files location, it will require a restart of ACM to become active. And if at any time you would like to go back to the default location, simply press the Reset button and copy the files back to the original location. Thank you for watching this AUTOSOL training session. If you have any questions, please go to our website, www.autosoln.com, and click on the support link for all available support options.